One of the most common reasons for incorrectly interpreting data stems from the difference between correlation and causation. If we use some logical notation borrowed from math, a correlation can simply be stated as both A and B either go up or down. You could also have an anti-correlation where when A goes up, B goes down. The difference with causation is typically one event happens before the other. In this case, if A, then B. In this case, causation is often a much stronger assumption and effect than merely a correlation. To make this a little bit more concrete, I want to go through a simple example. Let's say that as the number of movies produced in a year increases, the observed incidence of cancer in a population increases as well. Now you might be able to say that as the number of movies produced increases, people go to the movies more often and thus exercise less, increasing cancer incidence in the population. And while that may be true, an analyst might conclude a stronger relation between the number of movies produced and cancer incidence in a population to be a causation instead, perhaps leading to some serious actions being taken erroneously. If the relation between movies produced and cancer is completely spurious, and the true cause of the cancer incidence increase is due to some completely separate event, if the results that the analyst found are presented either on potentially wrong media, let's say an academic paper, rather than simply on their personal blog or maybe in an article, some serious consequences might be taken based off of, again, the spurious correlation. Let's say that a doctor sees a paper published based on this connection and relation that some analyst found, and then decides to recommend to all of his patients to stop watching all movies and TV because it increases cancer incidence. By misinterpreting a correlation to in fact be causation could lead to many misleading conclusions and thus serious consequences that others might take based on those conclusions.